There's no question about that.
Drilled right back into the Canadian zone. 11:30 to go in the first. No score in game five. Merrill's pass, a neat one. Petrie to Byron and out to Kotkaniemi. Up ahead for Anderson. In alone to the backhand. And stopped by Fleury. Rebound. They score. Kotkaniemi, the opener in game five. It's 1-0 Montreal.
And that's a play that the Canadians have used that, you know, they have that stretch pass, and Anderson with his speed, once he gets a step on you, forget it. He's going to the net. But after he cuts to the net, Kotkaniemi follows up in the play, and that's key. And it's a good play down low. Merrill made that great play on a nice pass, like you mentioned. Byron along the boards gets it up to Anderson, and he cuts to the net. And it's with his speed, there's no one going to catch him there. And he's on his forehand, goes to his backhand. But Kotkaniemi follows up, and it's 1-0 Habs.
So Jesperi Kotkaniemi beat Holden to the puck. He put it in on his backhand. 5 postseason goals this year. And Fleury, not very good body control as he slid out of position. A new line in the second period. Marchessault behind the net. Knocked it up on the boards. Merrill, good feed. And again, good short passes to carry it out for the Canadians. Suzuki headmans to Toffoli. Gets it back. Left wing, Nick Suzuki. Into the corner. Stops. His pass, a good one. There's a chance. They score. And it's Eric Staal off the bench. He drills it home. And it's 2-0 Montreal. Eric Staal with his second of the playoffs, and Nick Suzuki continues to shine.
Well, the Canadians struggled in their own end just a little bit because they didn't get it out. And finally, when they got it out, it's Vegas in their own end. They just can't seem to pick up the right people. And Canadians finally move the puck out. Danault gets hammered by Stone, but no problem. Gets it out of the zone. And then you're right. Suzuki comes in there, holds on to the puck, and makes a great pass. And everyone's looking. I don't know where they're looking. There's nobody in the slot area. And Staal is all alone, like you mentioned, comes off the bench. And it makes it 2-0.
Staal from Suzuki and Toffoli at 6:32. That's a big one. Eric Staal trying to get it out. He wanted to step past Gustafson and go the other way. Toffoli into the zone. Corey Perry to Caulfield. He gave it away to Mark Stone. 50 left in the Ford power play. Stone to the line. Knocked loose. Turned back the other way. Breakaway. Corey Perry trying to get some speed. Caulfield shoots and scores. Perry to Caulfield. 3-0 Montreal. Corey Perry ran out of steam, but he had an ace up his sleeve. It was number 22 on the right, and Montreal scores in the power play.
Yeah, Mark Stone just breaks his stick over the boards. He's the one that turned over the puck on the power play. The Canadians turn it up, and it's just a little move. Suzuki, you know, slaps it up to Perry. He's got a breakaway, but he's getting caught, and he sees Caulfield behind him coming, and he makes a backhand pass, and Caulfield makes no mistake, and the Canadians have a 3-0 lead down.
So Cole Caulfield with his third of the postseason, and he's not going to miss from there. You wonder, too, you were thinking the same thing I was, everybody was. Can Perry get to the net because he was flat-footed? But he knew where Caulfield was, so Perry just continues to shine. Amazing.
Yeah, and you just saw both defense, you know, coming back, and they both went on Perry, and that allowed Caulfield to be open. So
Petrangelo shot. Marchessault stopped by Price, and he swatted it away. It went behind the net. They get it back. Marchessault to Petrangelo. 1:10 to go. Toffoli cut it off. And one of the Vegas players went into the Canadiens bench. Suzuki into the empty net. Scores! Nick Suzuki, arms in the air, puts this one to bed. It's 4-1 Montreal.
And you're right, someone went in the bench. I was watching. I was trying to see who it was. But the Canadiens get the puck out, and that's it. It's 4-1, and there's a party going on in front of the Bell Center. Nick Suzuki, what a game. A goal and 2 assists. Great job along the boards. That's Toffoli that chips it out. And Suzuki makes sure, gets it on his forehand, a rolling puck, and buries it into the empty net.
And how about that celebration? You don't see him get that jacked up. Arms in the air and the big yell. Toffoli with another assist. And the Canadians are up 3 with 1:01 left. It's the Canadians who've really moved the needle here tonight in game number 5. Letting the clock tick away. The puck is in the corner. On Thursday night, game 6, the Canadians will have a chance to advance to the big dance. They beat Vegas 4-1. In game 5, and it's all over. Montreal with a massive effort tonight as they celebrate with Carey Price. They take it 4-1.
Yeah, and normally, you know, you talk about Carey Price having to be the number one star. He didn't have to be tonight. He made some saves, but man, everybody in front of him were the number one star, in my opinion.
Kotkaniemi, Staal, Caulfield, Suzuki, they did the scoring, but tell me a Canadian player who did not do his job tonight. You can't do it. Can you believe it? Montreal is one win away from advancing to the Stanley Cup Final.